back, and it's good to be alongside you and Tracy. Now, I've learned of a secret criminal investigation into a local taxpayer ripoff. Business owners are being accused of falsely claiming they were poor while taking free food and housing from those truly in need. The criminal investigation targeted three landscapers with two companies which have no connection.
All right.
Wayne Swank of Swank's Lawn Care.
Yo, yo, yo.
And Erica O'Neill Tufts and husband David of Two Tone Landscaping.
Yeah, we out here just chilling downtown, just relaxing, taking a cruise.
All three have been indicted on felony charges that involve fraud with food stamps, public housing assistance, or both.
You know, it's
criminal investigator Karen Sweet.
They're not entitled to this free housing and these food stamps.
Yeah.
The Tufts openly depict themselves on David's Facebook page as living a lavish lifestyle.
And that's just ride and cruise, baby, ride and cruise. Downtown Cleveland, that's where we at right now, doing our thing. We're just chilling. You know, BMW style, you know, doing it the BMW way.
Prosecutors say posting video of their fancy car and night on the town makes public assistance even more outrageous.
People who are living in free housing and getting food stamps would not be driving in a BMW convertible.
Prosecutors say Erica scammed the government out of food stamps while living here in public housing with her husband. Wayne Swank faces criminal charges for living in the Chardon home on rent vouchers and for collecting food stamps he wasn't entitled to. Prosecutors are accusing the three of cheating the system by underreporting their income.
That pisses me off.
It doesn't sit well with taxpayers.
When people are taken away from people that really do need it, I think they should be prosecuted to the full extent of the law.
I mean, he's claiming he doesn't make any money and he's got all these customers.
Criminal investigators did hidden camera surveillance and searched bank records. They found the two companies were maintaining yards and selling services to dozens of customers.
They were on the taxpayer's dime living in this housing and running fairly lucrative landscaping businesses from those locations.
But in court, the Tufts denied even owning a business when questioned by a housing attorney.
Have you been Thank successful you. In obtaining any customers who pay you for landscaping or mowing?
Not yet.
The housing authority requested the hearing and convinced a judge to evict David, who they said didn't qualify to live in public housing and run a business from there. Both Erica and David were charged with perjury.
It's unbelievable to me how blatant they were in their lies.
Pictures probably don't do it justice.
Investigators interviewed customers, including Tom Sopko, for further proof they were paying Swank and Tufts for their work.
It makes me mad.
The Painesville man was upset with Swank's installation of a French drain in his backyard.
It's very hard to walk on.
But he says he still paid Swank the original estimate of $5,500. Swank wanted $800 over the estimate, which Sopko paid.
All right.
Swank demanded $1,000 more, but Sopko refused to give him another dime.
Unfortunately, we did get hoodwinked on this one.
Swank and the Tufts aren't the first ones accused of ripping off the system. Authorities admit it's a system easily defeated by fraud.
Essentially, you take people for their word, correct?
We do.
The system may be flawed.
So you get paid cash?
Yes.
But the prosecutor says public assistance agencies have their hands tied.
They are not given the tools or the resources to independently verify that information. So it's a system that's set up to fail if you have people who are willing to take advantage of it.
Now, we reached out to all three, but they're not talking. Swank and David Tufts are pleading not guilty. Erica has yet to plea. The landscapers face possible jail time if convicted.
I tell you, Tom, taxpayers' blood must be boiling watching this, and the question they would all have is, how can we keep this from happening again?
Well, let me point out, Lou, this isn't the first time this has happened, okay? If these agencies had an investigator or two, which they don't, they could verify that the information on the applications is true. It would go a long way to stamping out fraud and giving benefits to those who certainly deserve them.
I'll tell you, this stuff just makes you so angry. It really does. Great report, Tom, and great to have you back.
It's great to be
All
back.
Right, thanks so much.
And alongside you guys. All right.
Well, in other news tonight.